Good morning. Good morning. We want to welcome everyone to Temoka United Methodist Church. Thank you for worshiping with us today here and online. I'll invite our online members to gather your communion elements for later in the service. We also want to say best wishes to Pastor John, who's recovering well from his oral surgery on Friday. We also want to have you sign your attendance in the pews. At the end are the attendance pads. Please pass those to the end. And if you have any changes or want to communicate with the office in any way, that's a good way to do it. There's a comment section there. Please read your bulletin. There's lots of great announcements. We want to especially lift up after service today, after Sunday school, is the children's ministry meeting where lunch will be served, and they will be meeting to discuss our upcoming events. Also, we want to make sure you're aware that next Sunday is, next Sunday, right? The fifth Sunday. We make a big deal of the times that there are five Sundays in the month, which happens four times a year. That is when we take up our noisy offering, which is a collection for the Florida United Methodist Children's Home in Osteen. Some of us went to visit it this past week. It was a beautiful day and an amazing campus and all the things that they do there with foster care and helping children in need. So we will take up a collection, and of course your paper collection is a welcome coins. We're going to dump it in our cans and make a joyous noise, and that's why it's called Noisy Offering. Then we'll also have a lunch afterwards, and there's a sign up for that also on the pews. So please register that you'll be joining us so we know how much meatloaf to make, and we ask that you bring a side to share. And one last announcement, I would like to thank Alma, our community outreach director. She put on a wonderful program with the Council on Aging on Saturday. We had 35 folks there, some folks from the community, and it was very informative. I think we'll be hearing more about the services that they can provide, and thank you, Alma, for that. It was very special. And now I'd like to welcome our mission and focus person, Jean.
Good morning.
Good morning.
In case some of you don't know me, my name is Jean Cody, and I would just like to say, to begin with, I am not a trainer. It is not a weight loss program. I am not a teacher, because some people you just can't teach anything to. I am a leader, and I do lead the class. I'll just give you a little bit of background on why I can do this. To begin with, I retired from YMCA in Connecticut after 30 years. I started out with calisthenics, went to aerobics, then we went to aerobics with music, and then yoga. Then I went into a preschool program and taught swimming. I moved to Florida in 2018, and I volunteered at the senior center for 3 years. And I left there because they wanted me to be certified. I'm volunteering my services. They want me to be certified and pay for liability insurance. So I said, thank you, but no thank you. At that point, I was at Riverview United Methodist Church as a member, and I started a class there, which continued for 5 years, and unfortunately, the church closed down. So here I am. We do no floor exercises. We don't get down on the floor because we have to call the EMTs to come and get us all up. So, you know, that is out, definitely. We start our program standing. We do stretching and bending and twisting and all that kind of stuff. We use weights. We have 1 pound, 2 pound, and 3 pound weights. And if anybody would like to volunteer or donate weights, we would gladly accept them. All that we have been donated. I haven't bought anything. I'm too cheap. If you go to a tag sale and they've got them cheap, pick them up. We can always use them. Then after we've done that, then we sit. And everybody says, oh, thank God, we're sitting. You know, you'd think that it was really a tough program. But anyway. So we sit and do legs and arms and, again, everything. Then we take a water break, which should only be a couple minutes, but everybody socializes. So then we sit, then we stand again in the back of our chair and do feet exercises. We do some balancing exercises. Again, some more bending, some walking, and then we sit again. Finally, we're sitting. This is our last part of the program. Again, stretching everything out. By the time we finish, I think we've used every part of our body except our ears, which have no muscles, and our nose, which has no muscles. But most of the part, the rest of us, we have stretched it out. We end up with a complete relaxation. Let your body go. And there's no pressure in the class. If we're standing and you want to sit, sit. I'm not going to say, oh no, you got to stand. You do what you can do. I don't know what your limitations are, so I'm not going to say to you, you have to do this. Like I said, I'm not a trainer. I'm not getting paid for this. I'm doing this because I love doing this. And I like doing it because, not only for you, but for me. Because if I didn't do it with you, I wouldn't do it at home. I'm like everybody else, you know? Your intentions are good, but you're not going to do it. So you do what you can do. You sit when you want to. You stand when you want to. If you don't want to use weights, that's fine. I will ask you to do one thing now. Raise your hands up. Okay, now bring those arms in close to your ears. Touching your ears. And you think, hey, I can do that. But do we do it often? No. But that's another part for your shoulders. We work a lot on our shoulders and our hips because this seems to be the hardest part for people to exercise with. We're not jumping, we're not running, we're not skipping, we're not hopping. We just have fun. I think we have fun. Everybody seems to enjoy it anyway. No pain. If you ache after the class, good. That means you found muscles that you haven't used before. But if you have pain, then that's something you overdone it. You should not have done that. We do not have, unfortunately, any men in our class right now. But we would like some. So please think about it. Our class is on Tuesdays and Fridays from 10 to 11. It doesn't cost anything. All you have to do is bring food. A can of soup, a can of vegetables, a box of cereal. I try to, by the month, 1 month, it was macaroni. Bring pasta. I don't care what kind. And I feel sorry for the men that pick up all the groceries out there because, oh my gosh, all of a sudden we've got all these boxes of food that they didn't have before. But they're going to a good purpose. One day it was pasta. 1 month it was soup. Last month it was fruit, or this month I guess it's, no, last month was fruit, applesauce, pears, even the little ones. I don't know what we're going to do this month, whatever. If I don't tell you what to bring, bring whatever you want. The only thing I do ask is make sure that it's not outdated. Because if it's outdated, it's just going to get thrown out. And if it's going to be outdated in 2 weeks, it's not good either, because when it goes to the pantry, wherever it goes, it doesn't mean it's going to go out that day or that week. It may be 2 weeks before it goes out. So please make sure that nothing is outdated. And that's it. Tuesdays and Fridays, except the first Tuesday of the month. The United Methodist women have their meeting. So other than that, hope to see you all there. Thank you.
Thank you.
If you'll please stand for the call to worship. Draw us nearer to you, blessed Lord, as we come together for worship. Let us sing with songs of gladness and fill our heart with joy. Help to consecrate us to your service. Descend upon us and fill us with your love. Please remain standing for our hymn 419. Standing for our affirmation of faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. I pray, dear Lord, lead me, Lord, lead me, Lord.
This time we're going to present our tithes and offerings as a presentation of our lives. I wanted to remind all of you and inform some of you that there is a little box on the side of the front pew. Some of you have asked recently, what is that? You may notice people putting in a dollar during communion when they come forward. Also, some people lay it on the communion rail. That goes towards something called the Good Samaritan Fund. It's a pastor discretionary fund that the pastor can use when he hears of a need of a member of our congregation, something private. They come to him. It's up to his discretion and a little bit of change to help them out if they need to. So that's what those little boxes are at the very front. It says Good Samaritan on it. It's a fund in the budget. Has a line, little line out of it. And if you would find it in your heart to contribute to that, that would be lovely. And now let's present our tithes and offerings.
Thank you.
You may be seated. Our scripture reading this morning is from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, chapter 12, verses 1 through 11. Now concerning spiritual gifts, brothers and sisters, I do not want you to be uninformed. You know that when you were pagans, you were enticed and led astray to idols that could not speak. Therefore, I want you to understand that no one is speaking by the Spirit of God ever says, "Let Jesus be cursed." And no one can say, "Jesus is Lord," except by the Holy Spirit. Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are varieties of services, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who activates all of them in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. To one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom, to another the utterance of knowledge according to the same Spirit, and to another faith by the same Spirit, and to another gifts of healing by the one Spirit, to another the working of miracles, to another prophecy, to another the discernment of spirits, to another various kinds of tongues, to another the interpretation of tongues. All these are activated by the one and the same Spirit who allots to each one individually, just as a Spirit chooses. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in your sight. Amen. If you have been in church the last few weeks, you will realize that we are continuing a series called Growing Up into Christ. We have learned about the apprenticeship period, the life of discipleship, and we are ready to go it on our own. Even to move on to help others learn to do and be what we have discovered. This is a natural extension of last week's topic, life of discipleship. This happens regardless of what kind of background we have. Having been given to and received so much with our association with others, the time has now come to give in return. How do we give in return? Each of us has unique gifts to offer. The book Network, written by Bruce Bugbee and Don Cousins, helps us discover our spiritual gifts, personal style, and the God-given passion for serving in the body of Christ. As noted in the book, it is putting the right people in the right places for the right reason at the right time. The church needs you, us, you and me. Not because the people to fill positions within the organizations, but we are an important and integral part of the body of Christ. We have a significant contribution to make. We have a ministry in the church and a mission in the world. Doing gift-based ministry is not optional. It is biblical. It is God's operating system for this church. Envision the goal. Enjoy the process and be equipped. Diligently serve as we have been created and called to do. We will glorify God and edify others. Natural talents are given at physical birth. Spiritual gifts are given at spiritual birth. Natural talents are God-given to all people. Spiritual gifts are God-given to believers. Both natural talents and spiritual gifts need to be identified and developed.
The spiritual gifts given to each person by the Holy Spirit are special abilities that are to be used to minister to the needs of the body of believers. There are many gifts. People have different gifts. Some people have more than one gift, and one gift is not superior to another. All spiritual gifts come from the Holy Spirit, and their purpose is to build up Christ's body, the church. No matter what gifts a person has, each gift is given by the Holy Spirit. We are responsible to use and sharpen our gifts, but we can take no credit for what God has given to us freely. We must never use our gifts as a means of manipulating others or serving our own self-interest. Because our gifts are unique to each of us, each person can play a different role in the church. Our gifts need to be used. They are given for the common good of the church. By using them, we contribute something specific to the church in return for all we have been given and for the nurturing we have received. It also makes us feel better about ourselves to know we are special and have special gifts. We are able to accept the fact that we can do specific things well. For a time when we are recognizing, organizing, and putting into practice our special gifts, we appear to be relatively self-centered. We have to look at ourselves to discover which gifts or talents we most want to use and to find out how to use them. In your bulletin today is a spiritual gifts inventory sheet, and they should be in all of them. Be honest with yourself as you complete the survey. This will give you a good idea what your special gifts are. If you are a new member or a relatively new member, please contact Pastor John and he will assist you in locating how to use your spiritual gifts in this church. And there's, in just a moment, we're going to talk about some of the various ways people can use their spiritual gifts. Sometimes people who have worked for a long time at one job or task, either in the church or in other areas, will discover at this stage that they have other talents. Then they will want to make a change. The church is a good place to explore new talents and skills in an accepting and loving environment. Sometimes we come to a responsible role by the loving prodding of someone else who coaxes us into taking on a leadership or productive role that we might not have felt ready for. Oh, but nobody ever does that. As we begin to fill the role, we find new strength and talent we did not know were there. Each of us has an area of responsibility that we can use for God. Our main concern is to be faithful to our tasks and succeed in it. This stage is closely allied with symbols that represent responsibility, authority, recognition, titles, praise from others, influence, respect, and allegiance. When we are fruitful, there are rewards, either personally or from the community of faith. I was asked to speak briefly about myself. I believe I was 10 years old when I performed my first community service. I felt so grown up. Give responsibilities to some of the younger ones. As I grew up, so did my desire to help others. Think about this. There are 168 hours in a week. How much of that time do you spend helping others? I have had broken bones and major surgery, and while lying in bed, I still think of ways to help others. Being involved in many community organizations, I can refer people to an appropriate agency. When community agencies will actually contact me for advice, that is a great honor, and for not for me, but for God. God gives me the strength to keep going. Success in life, regardless of how we define it, represents another outgrowth of faith for some. We might equate our success in life with the strength of our faith, with what we believe. And we draw on our faith in support of our productive lives. For us to be successful means to be fruitful. For some people, the form of productivity or fruitfulness may not take on external visible signs of responsibility, leadership, or success. Rather, it may be a sense of having reached a level of spirituality or maturity in the faith that leads us to desire to do something with what has been attained or our experiences. From experiences or crisis, we feel special and able to make our own unique contribution to others. Perhaps you have heard the phrase or seen it on t-shirts, shop until you drop. This is humorous. The same idea describes us here. We work so hard of whatever we are doing as part of our faith experience that we become weary in well-doing. We are burning out and frequently at the same time feeling unappreciated without knowing why. The more successful we are at this stage, or the more productive we become, the more tempting it is to slip into the idea of self-centeredness, even self-worship. We feel indispensable to the group. Life becomes a performance, an act, a play, in which we are the leading persons and all goes well. We cannot be vulnerable or look weak in front of others because we would be out of control. We are angry at God inside and very fearful of being found out. We look almost perfect to those around us. We strive so hard to be loved for what we have done rather than for who we are. We are ultimately very lonely people. Spiritual gifts are special abilities given by the Holy Spirit and distributed to every believer according to God's design and grace for the common good of the body. Your spiritual gift is not for you. It is given to you for others. Now, let's look at the spiritual gifts here at Tomoka United Methodist Church. First, we have internal. How do we serve in the church and its members? If you are a member of any of these following committees, please raise your hand. If you happen to be chair of this committee, please stand. Acolytes. Alder Guild, Card Ministry, Children and Adult Sunday School Classes, Communion Servers, and there is a sign up in the narthex for those who would like to become communion servers. Greeters, lay servants, membership care, nurture committee, offering counters, pastors, prayer chain participants, safety and security, staff parish relations committee, Stephen ministers, stretch class participants, technology staff, trustees, United Methodist men, United Methodist women, ushers, wings in the word. Now these are all connected directly internal. Now, the second external. These are the organizations outside listed on our mission board. And I want to particularly acknowledge Linda Silber for heading the entire missions committee. Linda, would you please stand? These are ways that we serve. Christine's Blankets, anybody who's donated to Christine's Blankets. Anybody that's donated to Council on Aging and their fundraising things that they've had. Faith, Social Justice. Family Renew. Florida United Methodist Children's Home. Halifax Urban Ministries, including Barracks of Hope, Star Center, and the Bridge of Hope. Our latest new one is Hinson Middle School, Palmetto House, our partner with Cuba Church, Provision Packs, Tomoka Elementary School, UMCOR, Women of the Word. If you have heard of a way to serve, either internally or externally, and want more information about it, please contact Pastor John or speak to someone who has raised their hands during this exercise. Internal committees are constantly looking for new people to join with them to get new and fresh ideas. So as the old cliche would be, ask not what this church or any organization can do for me, ask what I can do for them. And so, what is the best spiritual gifts? Gifts are great, but it's more important to know how to love. God has given his love as a gift. We love because he loved us first. Without love, all of the actions supposed to be gifts are empty. There's a reason the following portion of scripture is so widely known. Love is the best gift. Love is what matters most. Seek to love above all else, and the gifts will find their place. As I conclude this message today, let us be reminded of John Wesley's covenant prayer. I am no longer my own, but thine. Put me to what thou wilt. Rank me with whom thou wilt. Put me to doing. Put me to suffering. Let me be employed by thee or laid aside for thee, exalted for thee or brought low for thee. Let me be full. Let me be empty. Let me have all things. Let me have nothing. I freely and heartily yield all things to thy pleasure and disposal. And now, O glorious and blessed God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, thou art mine and I am thine, so be it. And the covenant which I have made on earth, let it be ratified in heaven. Amen.
Didn't Mary do a wonderful job? Christ our Lord invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sins and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sins before God and one another. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not always accepted the gifts the Spirit bestowed upon us, nor have we always used them for the common good. We have not always lived by faith or acted with your knowledge. We have failed to be an obedient church. Forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love for us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you have been forgiven and freed. Thanks be to God. Amen. Our hymn of preparation is number 347, the Spirit Song. Please remain seated.
Thank you.
be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and a joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. You formed us in your image and breathed into us the breath of life, delivered us from captivity, made covenant to be the sovereign God, and spoke to us through the prophets. And so, with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your holy name and join the unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. When the Lord Jesus ascended, he promised to be with us always in the power of your word and Holy Spirit. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died.
Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Let us pray. Pour out your Holy Spirit on all gathered here, and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and the blood of Christ, that they may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one in Christ, one with each other, one in ministry to the world, until Christ comes in the final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and your Holy Catholic Church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen.
Join us now as we pray for others. God of all mercies, we pause to lift up in prayer today all those who suffer in mind, body, and spirit. Hear us now as we name them. May your grace heal, comfort, and strengthen them in their time of need.
And now, with the confidence of the children of God, let us pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. At this time, we invite you to come forward for Holy Communion.
Thank you.
Eternal God, we give you thanks for this holy mystery in which you have given yourselves to us. Grant that we may go into the world in the strength of your Spirit to give ourselves for others. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Our closing hymn is number 378, Amazing Grace, verses 1, 2, and 6.
I want to thank Pastor Bob Williams and Elizabeth Flynn for assisting in this service today. See, it took three of us to take Pastor John's place. Let us pray. Serve your God with patience and passion. Be deliberate in enacting your faith. Be steadfast in celebrating the Spirit's power, and may peace be your way in the world. Amen.